The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And the people from the whole Judean countryside, all the people of Jerusalem, were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locust and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thongs of his sandals. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of our Lord. We enter into not only a new year of 2021, we come to the new season, the season of Epiphany, the season of light and realization and awareness, an inspiration of what has arrived and that which is now in front of us. Epiphany is the recognition of God with us, a reminder of who we are, and a discovery of who God is in Jesus with us. And the hope continues in a life together, which is a complete change of form or appearance into a more beautiful spiritual state, a state that enlightens us. We put away our Christmas decorations. We take down the lights that glow on our trees, highlighting a baby being born unto us, vulnerable and dependent, who then grows up and matures, and a ministry begins. A life of awe and mystery. But that luminous mystery moves out into the world. We see the season of Jesus as the light of the world, revealed to all nations, including the Gentiles. The season is less defined by the number of weeks, but dependent of when Easter comes. The season always begins with the baptism of our Lord Sunday, and it ends with transfiguration in full form. Now there is a cosmological determination to when this happens. Christians, for over 2,000 years, observed the stars, the dots of light that brighten the night sky. When the events are set in motion to orient us to something new on the horizon, found in the lights that illuminate in and each one of us, all over God's creation. The first Sunday following the full moon occurs on or just after the spring equinox on March 20th. When spring is on the horizon, new life begins its ascent, and Easter begins. God is telling us this every year, much like it is, he tells us in Ecclesiastes 3, there is a season to life and a time for everything. And in each and all of those seasons, we can see God at work. Epiphany is the season where we reflect on who Jesus is and who he becomes. Having lived most of my life in Iowa and living through many seasons with our farmers, these rhythms and seasons are familiar. Probably for all of us here in Iowa. Much like planting in the spring or growing throughout the summer and harvest in the fall. And winter creates that moment of pause, reflect, and it prepares us for spring. In other words, welcome to Epiphany. It is the winter months of reflecting, realization, and preparing for spring. We do this liturgically as a community of faith, from our Advents to our Christmases, and now in our Epiphanies. Much wisdom can be found in what God is doing around us, an awareness of what he embeds in his creation. So join me in this reflection, what it means for you and for me and for us here as a community of faith, as we prepare for new ways together with realization and hope. Epiphany is not only in my mind these days as we consider what's next for our life together as a church, but if we look around us, we can see it in the beauty within us as we appreciate the light of Christ in each other. Perhaps the most unique aspect of today's gospel lesson is the use of the Greek word schismoi, which literally translates, he saw the heavens being ripped apart, an act of breaking in or shaking out. This is where we get the word schism or schizophrenia, which has this idea of multiple things happening and multiple voices breaking into our reality. It is the reality of God moving into our lives, as it says here today in our gospel lesson. In verse 10, it says, and just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven. You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased. When the heavens are torn, the Spirit comes to Jesus and heavenly voices address him as Son. And at that moment of his death, he breathed out his Spirit. The temple curtains tear apart. God breaking in into our lives, enlightening the world. This happens in and starts with baptism. This happens in multiple ways and in multiple voices as we see God becoming realized. We can relate as we take a shower and we can see the snow on the ground. In the water that we drink, to feel a refreshing liquid replenish our bodies. This is God revealing himself to us and with us and all around us and in us. It is not lost on me as I reflect on 2020. 2020 brought about a year of deep division and pain and massive disruption and departure from normal routines as a society and as a community of faith. What feels like an enormous shift away from what we knew as comfort and complacency. We can almost say that we experience a schism in our society, hearing multiple voices, deeply torn by political divisions and blaming. Seeds of mistrust rise to the surface, where fear and darkness seems to be ruling the days, not quite knowing how to make sense of it all. We were changed in new ways and challenged profoundly. When we really think about it, unprepared in many ways, I believe many of you would join me in to bid 2020 a farewell. But we can look to 2021. With an epiphany spirit, with new eyes, one that begins with God breaking into our reality. The heavens, as it says here, tear open and a dove descends. And it says in our lesson today, and the multitude of voices becoming one voice. And the voice we hear is that says, "This is my Son, with you I am well pleased." Epiphany begins today with the baptism of our Lord. Much in the same way, it begins with ours, as the water carries us through this life. Like a ship in the ocean, it cleanses us in bath, and it sustains our life as we drink. It washes us clean, sustains our living, and journeys our exploration and discovery into a glorious promised land that we are unable to see by ourselves alone. We need God to show the way, to enlighten us, to reveal to us, and to lead us into a new life. With our eyes opened wide to the possibilities that lay before us, January begins a new year. Epiphany begins our ministry together. And in that beginning, it starts with baptism. Will this epiphany begin differently this year and in new ways? Much exploration as we move through this year together and through this new season. But please know that God is here, and He resides in each and every one of us. So next time you take a shower, seeing the droplets move down your body as you get cleansed, or you take a drink of water and feel it move down your esophagus as you get refreshed and renewed, or even when you find yourself floating down a moving river, not necessarily fighting the current, but using it as if it is leading you. This is indeed Epiphany, a new season, a new year together. What is God up to? Amen.